Good afternoon. Welcome to our parishioners and VTC visitors on the 20th Sunday in Ordinary Time. I am sure it happens to all of us that we pray for weeks and God did not grant our prayers. I can say that such situation brought us frustration and suffering. Perhaps we based on ourselves whether we know how to pray, whether God really exists. That is why today's gospel is so important. Why? Because a woman from today's gospel teaches us how to pray. We stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
in this Mass we especially pray for Yitka Aguda, for her soul. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, and my many faults and my errors, and what I have done, and what I have committed. To my fault, to my fault, to my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary of her Virgin, all the angels and the saints, and you and my brothers and sisters, to pray for me.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God, the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see, fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promise, which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, maintain justice and do what is right, for soon my salvation will come, and my deliverance be revealed. And the foreigners who join themselves to the Lord to minister to him, to love the name of the Lord, and to be his servants, all who keep the Sabbath and do not profane it, and hold my steadfast covenant, these I will bring to my holy mountain, and make them joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and their sacrifices will be accepted on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you.
Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you.
May God be gracious to us and bless us, and make his face to shine upon us, that your way may be known upon earth, your saving power among all nations.
Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you.
Let the nations be glad and sing for joy, for you judge the peoples with equity and guide the nations upon earth. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the people praise you.
Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you.
The earth has yielded to its increase, God. Our God has blessed us. May God continue to bless us. Let all the ends of the earth revere him.
Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, now I am speaking to you Gentiles, inasmuch then as I am an apostle to the Gentiles. I glorify my ministry in order to make my own flesh and blood jealous, and thus save some of them. For if their rejection is the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance be but life from the dead? The gifts and the calling of God are irrevocable. Just as you were once disobedient to God, but have now received mercy because of their disobedience, so they have now been disobedient, in order that by the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God has imprisoned all in disobedience, so that he may be made graceful to all.
Dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table.
Then Jesus answered her, "Woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter has healed instantly. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In today's Gospel, we see a woman whom we can describe in the following way. First, she is a mother who identifies herself with her daughter. She does not separate her life from the life of her daughter. Asking for help for herself, in fact, she asks for help for her daughter. The woman does not say, "Help my daughter," but "Help me. Take pity on me." These words show the unity in which they are living. The mother suffers with her daughter and asks for help. Another quality is her faith. The woman is not going to complain. She is so concerned about her daughter that no obstacles discourage her. And when Jesus is silent, and when refuses her request, she continues to insist. Another quality of her is trust. The woman, full of confidence, trusts to Jesus. Her faith is so deep that she does not allow any doubt to enter her heart. Today's Gospel shows the battle, fight of a woman with Jesus. You can say that the woman at first comes to Jesus as a miracle man. Therefore, she addressed Jesus with the words, "Son of David." Only later, she makes a change and calls Jesus the Lord, that is, one who has the authority. The words of the woman, "Have pity on me," were a request for compassion. Jesus, before he fulfilled her request, wanted her to recognize the true God in him. That is why Jesus wanted to convert her request into a prayer addressed to the true living God. At the beginning, Jesus did not turn to her with any words. He was silent. Such silence was a kind of response. This was Jesus' first reply. The woman asked Jesus to grant her the same grace as he granted to others. She trusts that Jesus would listen to her, but she was met with silence. Without being discouraged, she began to insist even more. Jesus again refused. used her. It seemed that this was his final response. Jesus maintained a strange attitude. It seemed that this was a lack of interest, maybe even contempt. But there was a purpose for this attitude. The woman did not rebel. She did not blame God. The woman fell before Jesus and said, "Help me." This fight continued. The woman was certain that Jesus could do everything, and in fact wanted to help her, contrary to all appearance. The woman also sensed that Jesus was acting in such a way to test her. She knew that she had to go through this situation humbly. The purpose of this test was to purify her faith. Even Jesus' brutal statement, "It is not good to take bread away from children and to throw it to the dogs," did not offend the woman. She only stated that the children are fed first, but later, even the dogs are given food. In other words, the woman said that she would be satisfied even with the remains. The woman's faith is a model of faith that saves. The woman was not a member of the house of Israel, and therefore knew that she had no right to salvation. She tried to reach Jesus in different ways. She paid no attention to how she was treated. She believed that pagans are also invited to the community with God. Her words showed her faith in Jesus and in his mercy, in his ability to overcome all barriers. In this way, the woman became victorious, but Jesus wanted her to gain victory in this way. When he was said, "Oh woman, your faith is great, let it happen to you as you wish," he recognized the greatness of her faith. She was victorious because through her faith, Jesus revealed his true divine power. In her words, she expressed an authentic desire. She did not demand the bread that the children eat. She wanted only leftovers. The woman used quite a shocking but convincing argument. She showed faith and won blessing. Her faith in this particular dialogue developed into complete trust in Jesus. This trust the silence of Jesus. The woman discovered that Jesus' silence was not related to rejection, but to the postponement of the fulfillment of the request. Jesus was not indifferent to this woman, but he wanted to lead her to true faith. To achieve it, he used certain methods, such as silence, denial, and humiliation. Jesus achieved his goal. Thanks to these methods, the woman managed to penetrate the depth of Jesus' heart and guess the meaning of his action. If Jesus had fulfilled her request immediately, the woman would never have recognized in Jesus the true God. Maybe you wonder why I so accurately describe this strange action of Jesus towards this miserable woman. Maybe because you are this miserable woman who has been tormented by life. Perhaps today, Jesus uses similar methods to bring you to true faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified by the Roman Empire, he descended into hell, and on the third day was risen from the dead. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand.
Holy Church, as you will be strengthened to offer the mercy and healing of Christ throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For world leaders, that they will enact law and policies to protect the most vulnerable members of our society, especially the unborn and the elderly. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the victims of violence, poverty, and neglect, for the healing touch of Christ will be brought to them in the midst of their struggles. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish families, that we will be our witnesses to God's love as a modern prophet in our communities. We pray. to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially members of our families, that they may be welcomed into the heavenly banquet, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty Father, hear our prayers through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed Lord, God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed Lord, God of all creation, of your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self through Christ.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For through his Paschal mystery, he accomplished a marvelous deed, by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people from own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth has full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy work of these gifts, we pray. By sending now your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. the mystery of faith.
Bring your death, Lord, and confess your resurrection.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the blood and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Hector, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the sacred moment, and for by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and
forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, Peace I give you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are they called to the supper of the Lamb. The body of Christ.
Amen.
My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive your sacramental, come at least spiritually into my heart, as through you have already come. I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray.